the field receives the one to go marker.
Coming to green.
All right, here we go again. Riley Hickman, I got a square off going into turns one and two. High horsepower screaming out of turn four. Here comes Riley to the outside. Mark Fields, the lead lap number one. Back into one and two, the Hustler got that laser chassis working hard on the top side. He's gonna try to stick it up under Fields and they complete lap number two. Well, Mark Fields has gotten some figured out as he's stretching away from Riley Hickman. Eric Hickerson sitting in third, trying to run him down, coming out of four. Hickerson all under the Hustlers. They battle turn number two. Riley, how wide and handsome, was trying to make this track work. Hickerson got him at the line. Hickerson's gonna let the three-time champion know, come on, baby, let me see what you got out of four. Good racing comes to the line, and Hickerson to clear him. Mark Fields trying to stun the world to win his first ever Southern All-Star Series event right here at his home track. Hickerson wants to make something work out of it as well, as these guys are getting lower to the bottom of the speedway. DirtOnDirt.com cruise with the champions, rookie of the year, Brad Skinner, at top five. Things are gonna get hairy in the points as those two continue. Him and Riley Hickman slugging it out. Only one position between the two. Mark Fields starting to show these boys this how you get around Thunder Hill Raceway. The 66 car has brought it into the infield, and that will end his night. Nine laps complete your top five. Mark Fields leads, Eric Hickerson second, Riley Hickman third, Scott Cook in fourth, Brad Skinner fifth, Brett White sixth, Ben Cottrell seventh, John Miner eighth, Josh Putnam ninth, and Jim Rogers round out your top 10. Mark Fields about to get into lap traffic with Mr. Taylor back there, Tommy T. Let's see if he can make something work. These guys are singing around this speedway, got the high horsepower out dialed in. And lap traffic is finally into play. Mark Fields, he'll put Tommy Taylor lap down with Eric Hickerson trying to get up under him. Riley Hickman picked up a big win here last time the Supers were on special. God almighty, these guys are screaming hard when they get into those corners. Lap times clicking off in the 12-second range. Mark Fields up under Finley four to put him on lap down. Track starting to get nice and black. Put a great surface on. Riley Hickman just almost lost it in the middle of turn number two. And Kev Finley's gonna take it off the banking with Tommy Taylor as well. We stay green flag racing as the cars are slowly starting to drop out. Jim Rogers battling with the 01 machine as they go into 1-2 of Ben Cottrell, and he'll snatch around him on the high side. The Dirt on Dirt Rookie of the Year starting to make some noise coming through the pack. Eric Hickerson trying to run your leader, Mark Fields down. They come out of turn number four. Halfway in, halfway to go for Mark Fields as he crossed the stripe. Parkville's trying to pull the Tennessee two-step. But in the famous words of Tupac, gangsters don't dance, they boogie. And he is boogieing on down in West Tennessee tonight as he's checking out on the field. Eric Hickerson starting to close up the gap on him. The 74 John Minan right now sitting in the way between the two. Mark Fields trying to shock him, trying to seal the shot to the field and take home a big win. Mark Fields will become the second first-time winner if he can hold on. Putnam moving up into the eighth position after that hard crash. Topside actually starting to make a little comeback right now. Scott Cook, your third place machine. Excuse me, your fourth place machine moving up. Hickerson is up there and going to go around Jeff Minan on the outside as they head down the backstretch. Mark Fields still decimating the field tonight. Man, oh man, Mark Fields. One of these West Tennessee boys saying, I ain't gonna play no games with this field tonight. $4,000 has got my name on it and you're gonna have to pry it out of my hands if you want it. 28 laps complete with 12 to go in this one. Jim Rogers getting close to going a lap down with 11 laps complete so far as the leader heads down the backstretch. He has got this car filled in and starting to embarrass these boys as he's continuing to beat on them tonight. 10 laps left. Mark Fields delivering a slobber knocker of a race. WrestleMania style. The way he just jumped off turn number two, Macho Man ain't got nothing for a flying elbow off that way. He is still showing out on this one tonight. Mark Fields running Jim Rogers down as they have 33 laps complete. No caution since the green first lap has been complete. Mark Fields trying to go wire to wire. Six to go this time by. Five to go this. Oh, caution on to the speedway in the middle of one and two. The 44 Brett White going around for a little spin. Put it in spin cycle. Mark Fields, he gets back to it. Pipe it up out of four. Here we go. Riley Hickman trying to pull a sucker move on the number 98 of Eric Hickerson. Here comes Brad Skinner to the inside, battling with Scott Cook. They're going to come around with four to go. Riley Hickman under Hickerson for second. Give it to Riley Hickman at the line. Great racing, them guys trying to keep those wheels planted in. Three to go this time by. Brad Skinner, oh, they're getting high, wide, and handsome. Scott Cook battling with Brad Skinner for the fourth position. He'll take it. Bullhorns are out, two to go this time by. Mark Fields. Moonwalking on these boys down the back stretch. They're gonna take the white flag one more time to go. Mark Fields said, look, I'm all the way up out of turn number four. Living handsome and wealthy. They can't touch it. Fields will take the win. Riley Hickman second and Hickerson third. Skinner fourth and Scott Cook around out your top five. Yeah, 26, 4, 1, 98. Here's your race winner, Mark Fields!
Daddy, can I get up
there?
Yeah, buddy, get up there.
Woo!
right, Mark. I know you ain't used to this kind of stuff, so we're going to have to see where we can work on it.
That's right. That's right.
All right, man. The second first time ever winner in 2 weeks. You come to your home track. You basically put your foot in their rear end tonight. Do you think you know that you can show these boys how to get around this speedway?
Well, I've been around here 20 years. I started my senior in high school. I've got several laps around here. And my first night, track ever run, I'm a little emotional.
Oh, you good, my friend.
Watch my dad run the first night. Dad run the first night this track ever run. He's, this size, you know, watching him, it's pretty amazing.
Definitely, man. I know this has been a kind of a dream come true to win an event this type of magnitude, especially with this kind of series, man. And I know you got young ones that are proud to have you as well as the home base. But throughout that race, man, I know Riley Hickman, he made a late race charge in the last closing laps. Did you think you were going to have the car to hold him off?
I never knew. Guys in front just told me to stay low in one and two, and they thought I'd be okay. But you never turn your close your eyes on Riley Hickman or any of the other ones in the field. It's any given night, any one of them can beat you.
Now, definitely, you were kind of pulling one of those old Michael Jackson moves. You was kind of moonwalking on half of this field, and a couple of times you passed a couple of them at the same dang time. So how's that going on, buddy?
Just get them when you can.
Definitely. Any of your sponsors you want to thank for this big one?
Well, I have Legend Steakhouse. They own me all the time. Johnny Fleming. Brass Lantern, he's very good. I've got Doss Brothers come on, and Specialty Cleaners, and also Fields Auto Sales. He's pretty huge in this organization right here.
So he's showing you some love back there, buddy. That's what he's doing. But definitely congratulations for your Southern All-Stars winner tonight, Mark Fields.
Thank you. I've got one more thing. Me and 72-year-old dad got up this morning to go to Cleveland, Tennessee to pick his car up. Randall Chupp and the Wolfpack. We've joined the Wolfpack, and I think it's going to be pretty good.
When you got the showstopper turning wrenches, man, that's enough said right there.
That's right.
There we go. Thank you. We're going to go on down to our second place, man. Mr. Hickman, definitely fans, show him some love, man. First time ever winning a major event, especially in your hometown.
What?
I don't know. What's going on?
Just riding around.
Just riding around. Definitely, we're down here with our set. I might want to ride with you on that next one, though.
I don't know,
dude. I don't know. Can I ride, though? Can I at least drive?
It might mess up the right side.
What you trying to say there, man? We I can match you on that belly department.
I hear you.
Definitely. We're down here with our second place man tonight, the three-time and defending Southern All-Star Series champ, Riley Hickman. You are the odds-on favorite coming on to this event based off past results and your performance, but unfortunately came one position short, man. What was going on out there?
You fall asleep every once in a while, and it is what it is. Congratulations to Mark and Shorty and them guys are great people, and they deserve it more than anybody else. They're well known over in this area, and I love coming to this place. You know, we get to come once or twice a year, and it's always been really good to me to come over here and to come out of here with a second. It was a good points night for us, I'm sure, and so we'll go on to the next one. I think just by looking at tires here, I think I was harder than most of these cats out here. So our stuff kind of picked up there at the end, and that was one reason I could get around Eric there on that restart and be able to go on. But it is what it is. It's racing, and get a load in the box and go back home.
Well, definitely you've kind of debuted into the laser camp as well as CVR as well. We definitely got to show Chip Vane some love there. But in that laser camp, how much more has it been trying to help and elevate your big motor program that you've been working on?
It's up and down. We race so much different stuff. And when you got three different cars sitting there in the shop and everything is different, and you try to take notes the best you can, and it can be kind of mind-blowing at times. And, Urkel and I will, we'll be scratching our heads, and we just do the best we can. And so we're definitely getting there with this laser car. It's it wants some different things, you know, and that than what our other stuff wants. So we'll just we'll keep after it, and hopefully we can get there.
Well, it sounds like a plan. We will see you down at Sonora Raceway, where you got half the field scared of you already. So we'll see you then.
Third place, right?
It's there.
Yes. Yes, please. On video.
We're down here with our third place man here at the Thunder Hill Raceway. Eric, you started outside the pole. You gave it a good run, man. Well, no, excuse me. You started there second row inside, and you came out. You swung. You fought hard, but you came up just a little bit short, man. What was going out there?
Car was pretty good. We had a hard time trying to make a tire choice, and actually changed the right rear right before we got in the car. And I'm going to blame it on it. You know, that caution come out, we really didn't need it. And right rear sort of glazed over. And, oh, well, you know, that's the way that sport is. You know, you make a choice, and it either works or it don't, you know. And it didn't work, but, I mean, we still third and had a pretty good run, so can't complain.
Definitely. I know you was one of the hometown favorites to come into this event and pick up that win. How special would it have been if you were sitting in victory lane right now, $4,000 richer?
Oh, man, it'd been great. I'd probably been like Mark, a little emotional about it. But, man, it'd been great. But, you know, I'm proud Mark won. He needed this, and he run a good show. And you can't say nothing about that. And, you know, I mean, he was the fastest car here and fastest car won. So.
Well, definitely. We're looking forward to seeing you at our next events, Eric. Appreciate you, brother. All right, thank you, race fans, for having the Southern All-Stars. We're looking forward to September the 3rd when we will return to this very fast high bank bull ring. And thank y'all for allowing me to grace y'all presence over the mic.